Welcome. Let me thank you for joining me again. Last we spoke, our little Oregon Trail caravan had just arrived in Pullman, Washington from Fargo, North Dakota. Compared to the cold, dark winter we had just made it through, my high hopes gathered strength across the waves of the golden grain. So, I did it. I jumped right in, and I got a full-time job within a week of getting to town, starting at Evergreen Tire. $10 an hour for a working interview. Yes, it was a fucking nightmare. And I got to work, right? There's cars all over the place, working on a Dodge Durango timing chain, and looking around at all the projects, right? And I'm like, am I the only mechanic that works here? And you know, at that point, I had survived some shit. So I followed my gut and I threatened to quit. And it was the smartest thing I ever did. And I actually had to threaten to quit on a few other instances. And I won't throw around any numbers, but I definitely made more money than when I owned my own shop. And that was a major achievement. With great support from my partner, I was able to continue my quest to learn how to grow a marijuana plant. And I had some excellent successes where a coworker gifted me a single seed. And this is what that seed turned into. This was time well spent. And honestly, growing this one single plant was a major influence for an upcoming career change. So there I was making good money, I was making other people money, I was fixing people's problems, and before I knew it, wham, hit with complacency. There I was, working as hard as I possibly could to make everyone around me as much money as possible, and to help as many people and get as many things done as I possibly could, and it cost me half of my thumb. It really was a major setback, being my good hand and all. I had to relearn every job. Hell, I had to relearn how to write. Returning to work was nothing but a steady flow of flashbacks, constant reminder anytime my tender nub brushed up against anything. However, all things considered, I'm a better man for it. I still have most of my thumb, and if that's the worst thing that's going to happen to me after 20 years of working on machinery, then I'm doing just fine. I put all my hard work and my good position to work and paid off all of my partner's credit card debt, as well as set up a very nice rainy day fund. It gave us the option to consider relocating again, as there was an opportunity for her to move up. Now, this is despite the fact that my position had turned into a career that had better prospects immediately than anything in front of us. However, believing that I was nobly playing the long game, setting up my partner to shoot for the stars, as winter faded into spring, it was obvious that changes were again in the air. I felt like my relationship was stronger than ever before. Part of me felt like I should stay at this job. It really felt like family. But once you've invested so much into a person that you believe is your partner, you have your blinders on and you will follow that person until you die or you have senses knocked into you. Seeing in that neither of those things had yet happened to me, I packed up with my partner, and she got a job in Corvallis, and unfortunately we're not able to afford a place in Corvallis right to start off, so we actually end up moving towards Lebanon, where she has a little bit of a commute. I'm all hyped up about having literally just kicked my career's ass and finding out what's going to happen next. But I'm going to have to ask you to please rejoin me for the next episode to find out how this story connects with the Shasta Trinity VW Rabbit Ranch.